Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing well. I hope you guys are staying safe. Today we are talking about reasons why you should take the CFA program. Welcome. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Happy. I make videos on personal finance, money management, budgeting, investing, saving, studying for the CFA program, motherhood, and all that kind of stuff. If that is the kind of content that interests you, please subscribe in the subscribe button right here below. So to begin with, what is the CFA program? Let me read from the CFA Institute's website. The CFA program is a three-part exam that tests the fundamentals of investment tools, valuing assets, portfolio management, and growth planning. So the CFA program is typically completed by those with background in finance, accounting, or business. Once you take the CFA program and you've passed those three exams and you have the experience, you can use CFA designation beside your name. So the number one reason why you should take the CFA program is you love finance, you want to know more about finance, you love the concepts of investing, you want to know more about investing in shares, investing in bonds, how to value a company, what are the kind of metrics you're looking for when you're valuing a company, you want to know more about portfolio management or asset management, what are the things you should look for, or you want to know more about wealth planning. Okay, fine, I have maybe an institution or a high net worth individual, what are the things that I should look at when I'm planning for them, planning their investments? What kind of advice should I give them? What should I be looking for when I'm analyzing a company? So all things finance, you love these things and you want to increase your knowledge on it. I remember just before I took the CFA program, I was thinking, okay, fine, I want to take a professional qualification. But at the time, I didn't like accounts as much, so I was like, I want to take something that deals with finance. Of course, now that I'm in the industry, I know accounting is just as important, and sometimes you need some accounting knowledge. You need accounting knowledge when you're valuing companies. You need to understand their financials, and that requires accounting. But yeah, at that time I was like, oh, okay, let me just do finance. But of course, there's some things that are intertwined, but in the end, that was my thinking when I took the CFA program. Another reason why you should take the CFA program is it increases your job prospects. Just having the CFA designation, or at least even taking one or two exams, depending on what kind of market you are in, it increases your job prospects. It opens some doors that would not ordinarily be open to you. So the question of whether you'll get in is something else, but just because you have the CFA designation, it will open doors for you. You might find that maybe recruiters are contacting you more on LinkedIn just because they see you are a CFA charter holder, or like in Tanzania, there are not a lot of charter holders. So just because you finished, maybe you've completed and passed an exam or two, that gives you an edge. So it might open doors for you. Some of the career options for you if you are taking the CFA program would be consulting. Consulting, usually they have like a corporate finance division where they do all things valuation, financial due diligence and stuff like that, or fund management, asset management, investment banking, investor relations. So there are quite a number of job opportunities for you if you're taking the CFA charter holder. I've made a video on different career options for you if you're taking the charter holder. I'll leave a link to the video right here. Another reason why you should take the CFA program is it makes you stand out. It makes your CV stand out. If you're among your peers and you're the only one who has taken the CFA program, or you're a charter holder, it just makes you stand out because everyone just knows how hard the exam is, how few charter holders are. So you just stand out. Like I said earlier, it opens some doors for you. Whether you actually get in is another issue, but at least it's a stepping stone. It will open some doors for you. Another reason why you should take the CFA program is that it is globally recognized. It is one of the designations that is worldwide recognized, whether in US, whether in UK, whether in Africa, it is recognized. So yes, so sometimes maybe you've just gone to a normal university, but just because you've taken the CFA program and it is globally recognized, you stand out. People recognize that qualification. You might find out that recruiters are approaching you more. Just because it's globally recognized. I think there are currently more than 170,000 investment professionals who are safe charter holders, and they're worldwide. They're recognized worldwide. So yeah, you should take it, and it is globally recognized. There are societies, you become a member of a society, and yeah, there are all these advantages to becoming a member. Maybe they host events, or they can sometimes they bring in people to speak on subjects that maybe you would not even have thought. Or yes, sometimes it would be about investment and whatnot, but another time it would just be about maybe speaking, how to make yourself stand out, and all these good things that maybe you would not know ordinarily pay for such courses. And a final reason why you should take the CFA program, and I really wanted to put this reason in, is because it teaches you about discipline. When I took the CFA program, when I was doing those exams, that is when I knew the value of discipline, the value of hard work. And you come to recognize that if you really want something, you're going to set time for it. You're going to do anything so that you can achieve it. I talk about discipline because for you to be able to pass those exams, you really need to be disciplined. You need to, maybe it could be waking up early, read every day for maybe a whole year or a couple of months so that you can finish the syllabus. You just really need to be dedicated, and it makes you know that, okay, fine, after a while you start knowing and figuring out, okay, this is a distraction, I don't need to do this, okay, this is the price, I want to get this, and this is what I'm going to do so that I can achieve it. So if there's anything, and I think this is one of the most important things that the CFA taught me, was that if you want anything, you are going to achieve it, and it really needs discipline. Because I remember at the time I was doing my exams, I used to wake up at like 4 because I was working, so I needed to wake up at 4 so that I read for like 2 hours before I leave the house and go to work, and then after that I stay behind again, read again another 2 hours. So it was just a whole cycle of reading, working, reading. And yes, your social life will suffer for a bit, but after you finished, there are some rewards to it. So yes, CFA really teaches you about discipline. If you're not disciplined, really, I'm not sure if you can pass that exam. I'm not sure. So it teaches you the value of discipline. Even nowadays, I know for sure, if there's something I want to do, I just need to set time for it, I need to be disciplined, and I need to do it consistently, because that is the only way you're going to achieve what you've set your mind to. So that's all, guys. Those are the reasons why you should take the CFA program. If there are any other reasons, please leave them in the comment section down below so that we can all learn from each other. If you've liked this video, you might also like my other video here, where I talk about the career options for you if you're taking the CFA program. And career options, especially if you're maybe in Tanzania, Kenya, Uganda, if you're in East Africa and you're taking the CFA program, yes, what are the career options for you? I know there might not be as many as if you're in other developed markets, but I have a video here which tells you what other career options for you if you're taking this program. If you've liked this video, please don't forget to click the like button. If you've not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe right here. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.